Hello everyone and welcome to this episode of Ignition Time. As President Biden starts to ramp up the PR strategy for the infrastructure package, for the Build Back Better agenda, which is designed around clean jobs, around essentially preparing us for the new American economy, American economy 2.0. There is a focus from 21 Senate Democrats for a fourth stimulus check, for reoccurring stimulus checks. Yep, you heard that right. For an extension of unemployment benefits beyond the deadline of September 6th. And they want President Biden to include this in the infrastructure package. Folks, if you thought the $1.9 trillion American rescue plan was big, I think what we are about to see is even bigger. Here's some brand new reporting from CNBC. You'll see the headline from CNBC. 21 Senate Democrats urge President Biden to put reoccurring stimulus checks and unemployment aid extension in the new recovery plan. So 21 Senate Democrats, led by Ron Wyden, are pushing President Biden to include more checks, to include more stimulus checks and unemployment benefits. In fact, let's show you this letter on your screen from these 21 senators that was sent to the president. Now, this is the important part of the letter. We urge you to include reoccurring direct payments and automatic unemployment insurance extensions tied to economic conditions in your Build Back Better long-term economic plan. This crisis is far from over and families deserve certainty that they can put food on the table and keep a roof over their heads. Families should not be at the mercy of constantly shifting legislative timelines and ad hoc solutions. Now, this is the really important part of the letter. There are several reasons to prioritize both reoccurring payments and enhanced unemployment insurance. First, these two forms of payment are effectively together. Unemployment insurance has replaced lost income for millions who have lost their jobs, but millions of others do not qualify for unemployment insurance after seeing their hours reduced, switching to lower paying jobs, or temporarily leaving the workforce to care for family members during the pandemic. Because remember, these individuals, I want our viewers and subscribers to know, do not qualify for unemployment insurance. Therefore, essentially, this proposal of reoccurring stimulus checks to these individuals. Direct payments, meaning reoccurring stimulus checks, are crucial for supporting struggling families who are not reached by unemployment insurance. An Urban Institute study suggests, and there's a link to that study through this letter. By the way, you'll get a link to this letter in the description section below. An Urban Institute study suggests that a single direct payment of $1,200 combined with an extension of enhanced unemployment insurance and other assistance could keep 12 million people out of poverty. Adding a second direct payment could keep an additional 6.3 million people above the poverty line. The letter also continues. Second, data shows that direct payments and enhanced unemployment insurance are among the most effective forms of relief available. Not only do these payments help keep families out of poverty, but they act as economic stimulus by increasing spending and supporting jobs. When the CARES Act relief checks ran out, poverty rose. This, in fact, is true. I've done videos talking about this on our channel, and many families saw spiraling debt. Automatic stabilizers will give families certainty that more relief is coming, allowing them to make the best decisions about how to spend their relief payments as they receive them. Families should not have to worry about whether they'll have enough money to pay for essentials in the months ahead as the country continues to fight a global pandemic. Folks, there have been some talks about a fourth wave, and I understand our viewers need quick cash now. They need to put food on the table. You need to be able to keep the lights on. You need to be able to pay rent. So that's what this letter is talking about. Let's continue. Almost 6 in 10 people say the $1,400 stimulus payments set to be included in the rescue package will last them less than 3 months. In other words, the $1,400 stimulus checks are going to last people less than 3 months. And the letter continues. Third, reoccurring direct payments have wide support from both the general public and economic experts. Polling shows 65% of Americans supporting reoccurring cash payments for the duration of the pandemic. This includes support from 54% of Republicans and 60% of independents. Economists support the idea too. More than 150 economists recently wrote an open letter supporting automatic stabilizers as part of a strong recovery and warning against repeating the mistakes of the Great Recession from over a decade ago, when an insufficient response led to unnecessary suffering, particularly among low-income workers. And they end the letter by saying, as you have said, now is the time for boldness. As you prepare your Build Back Better plan for long-term economic recovery, know that we are ready to work with you in supporting recurring direct checks and extended unemployment benefit insurance payments to support Americans who are still struggling during the pandemic. And I want our viewers and subscribers to know that a number of prominent Democrats signed this letter. This letter was signed by Ron Wyden, also by the number two Senate Democrat after the Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer. This is Dick Durbin, the Budget Committee Chair Bernie Sanders, the one and only from Vermont, and Banking Committee Chair Sherrod Brown, who's a Democrat from Ohio, and Senator Elizabeth Warren, the Democrat from Massachusetts. And folks, they're already getting a lot of support from progressives, and you can be sure they'll get a ton of pushback from Republicans and conservatives. Here's a quote from Greg Nassif, who's a spokesperson with Humanity Forward. This is what he said in a statement to Fox Business. These 21 senators have joined the overwhelming majority of the American people in calling for more checks. This is about more than giving families the support they need. This is about protecting our economy and securing an equitable future. I want you to know that we are expected to see stiff opposition, some very strong pushback from Republicans, including the Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell, who is not going to support this at all. I believe that we are not going to see a single Republican, either in the House or in the Senate, support the plan for reoccurring stimulus checks, as well as extension of unemployment benefits beyond September 6th as part of the Build Back Better agenda. In fact, it's quite likely no Republican will support the Build Back Better agenda to begin with, especially if it includes components like this, because this is going to make the Republicans run in the opposite direction. So that's it, everyone. Let me know what you think of this incredible letter, the push, if you will, not only for reoccurring stimulus checks, but also for extension of unemployment benefits from these Democrats in a strongly worded letter to the White House that was actually drafted a while back. We were able to get our hands on that draft and show it to you, our viewers, at Ignition Time. As always, you'll get a link to all of our resources, including that letter, in the description section below. So make sure to check it out. If you learn something new from this video, all I ask is you please click the like button, please subscribe, please enable notifications. I would really appreciate that. That really helps out the YouTube algorithm. I want you to know that I work hard on this channel every single day for you. For me, it's not about the red or the blue. It's about the red, white, and blue. I'm not Democrat. I'm not Republican. I'm American. We are all Americans first. I believe help should go to those who need it the most. Has there been some amount of fraud with all of this stimulus? Yes. Are we in too much debt as a country? And is that debt essentially going out of control? We're over $30 trillion in debt. We're getting close to a very, very challenging point. Yes, we are at that point. But we are at a moment in our country where we are at a crossroads. We need to make a decision now as to whether we'll help those who are the most vulnerable amongst us, because I believe if we don't do it now, we never will. And I do believe that at this moment in time, the decisions that are made by the White House, by the Democrats and the Republicans will impact the country for generations. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, please click like, please subscribe, please enable notifications. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next episode of Ignition Time. Take care. Bye.